As a Christian, you have a warmth in your heart. This is tremendous. Because as a father, I understand what it really means more now that I'm a daddy. This is a picture of my cheeky boy son, Sean. And Sean has a special relationship with me. I mean, he doesn't need to do a lot of things to get my attention. Say, for example, he sleeps in his own room, and sometimes in the middle of the night, there will be thunderstorm, lightning, and thunder cracking, and he gets scared. So what he does, quite frequently now, is that he climbs down his bed, and he brings his bolster, he brings his Mickey Mouse, he brings his blanket, and comes to our room. Suppose now he brings all that, because he's scared of his own room being on his own, he comes to the door of our room, and suppose Sean kneels down, puts his hand together, and say, "My dear, glorious, merciful daddy," or not daddy, "my king, would you, in your mercy, allow your subject to come into your precious privileged room, that I may perhaps, perchance, climb up and seek that comfort and shelter with you. I ask this humbly, amen." Do you think Sean will ever do that? You know what my son does? He just grabs the Mickey Mouse, the bolster, the blanket, and very bochap, he just comes to our bed, puts it all onto the bed, he climbs up, and when we are in sleep, dreamland, we open our eyes, see Sean, he just gives us a cheeky smile. And he positions himself perpendicular to us. His head is on my wife's tummy, his legs are on me, and he sleeps comfortably there. He doesn't have to do a lot of gymnastics or routines to be with us. But this privilege is unique only to Sean. None of you can ever do that. You can't. But as a son, he knows he can have intimacy with his father. And that's the way God wants us to relate with him. That we will know we can call him Abba, Papa, Daddy, Father. Do you know that Jesus taught us to pray like this? Jesus taught the disciples to pray, "Our Father, which art in heaven." Now, I think there's a beautiful poise and balance in that address. Father speaks of the nearness, the immanence of God. And in heaven speaks of the greatness, the transcendence of God. Don't lose that. Don't lose the nearness of God and the greatness of God in your life, in your perspective of God. It's got to be brought into tension. But nevertheless, when Jesus taught the disciples to pray, "Our Father," it is revolutionary. It was cataclysmic. Why? Because for thousands of years, the Jews have never prayed to God individually, "Father." In 39 books of the Old Testament, over thousands of years, they address God as Father only 14 times. And each time they address it as a nation, but not as an individual. And so when Jesus prayed and taught the disciples to pray, this is how you address God, "Our Father in heaven," it was mind-blowing. But that's how we are called to pray. Why? Because Jesus prays to God the Father the same way. 21 recorded prayers of the Lord Jesus Christ, out of 21 times, 20 of it is addressed to God as Father. The only time it is not is when Jesus was hanging on the cross, where he said, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And on the cross, he was not there as a son, but he was there as a sacrifice. But other than that, he addresses God as Father. And because you are in Christ, you address God as Father. What's the practical outflow out of this? It's this. When you pray, pray like a child. You can pray like a child. You don't have to have eloquent prayers, you know that? You don't have to have Queen's English when you pray. You don't have to have long, elaborate prayers. You don't have to, like what I said, "Our dear, gracious, heavenly, majestic, heavenly, great God, Father, la 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 la. Thy servant is so unworthy because of la 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 la." And you almost sing a song, and you don't get to the point. Because you feel you got to back it up with all these qualifications. No. My son can come to Jason Lim. And he doesn't have to say, "My dear, gracious, grand, glorious king of the Lim family, my humble petition to you, henceforth, if thou may lend me your ears, I will be eternally grateful, and I will be a good boy and serve you. If thou may, can I have an ice cream, please?" I mean, Sean, just tell me what you want. You don't have to do all those things. I think one of the best prayers in the Bible is simply, "Lord, save me." Is that a cry of a child to a father? And if you pray like a child, you also don't have to pray repetitively, you know. It's like a son asking a father, "Can I have chocolate ice cream, please? Can I have a chocolate ice cream with chocolate chips and in a cone, chocolate ice cream." If you see my son do that, you think, what a horrible father this is. And this is the weirdest son in the world. But you know, that's how we treat God. We think that he's an idol. We think that he's deaf. We think that he doesn't see. We think he doesn't know. We think he doesn't care. No, he's your heavenly father. Pray with that assurance and confidence.